Hey guys, here again. All right. This is egg preservation means year-round abundance. I still remember the excitement of collecting our very first eggs. Yep, I do too.
Tell us tomorrow.
And I can't wait to be able to do it again. And I'll probably take you guys on that journey. We dreamed, we planned, and then it finally happened. We had our own hens and they were laying. But those first rewards were only the beginning of my egg education. Same. Just like other parts of our homestead, egg production ebbs and flows with the seasons. In the spring, our layers produced mountains of eggs that took over our countertops. In the winter, however, production slowed down. There were days we didn't collect enough, even for the day's baking, and I found myself buying eggs just to keep up. No, I just didn't preserve them properly. I wish I would have. Simultaneously, our laying hens needed more feed to keep them strong and warm in the harsh weather. Buying feed and eggs at the same time is not the homesteader's dream. As I considered this natural rhythm, I knew there must be some way to harness the spring bounty to use in the leaner, less productive wintertime. Now, it's funny because what I found with that Kalmbach, Kalm, BACH, Kalmbach Extraordinary Layer Feed. That stuff worked so well. That particular brand worked so well. And I bought the Extraordinary Layer Feed, the Kalmbach Scratch Grain, shoot, there was another one.
If you really cared about Sully, you wanted to be happy again. You'd want to get off this
I think I also got the pellets too.
life.
And I kind of combined it, as all of their feed. The pellets I started just like sprinkling on the ground outside, and their layer feed I would put in the feeder. They loved the layer feed. But I did find that with a Kalmbach Extraordinary Layer Feed, our chickens laid all winter. So,
No,
depends on what you're feeding them. The
I
pursuit of egg preservation has taken me down a variety of paths, and I've leaned more than I could have imagined. I've learned more than I could have imagined. I've learned a bit too, you know. I've discovered methods of safely storing eggs for weeks, months, and even years. I've refound nearly lost historical egg preservation methods and shared them with the millions of others through YouTube. It is ironic to the modern technology to preserve old-fashioned food preservation methods. Isn't it ironic to use modern technology to preserve old-fashioned food preservation methods? And a lot of other methods, that have to do with homesteading. Most importantly, I accomplished what I set out to do. I found a variety of ways to feed my family nutritious eggs from our own chickens, even when our laying hens aren't laying. Here are just a few of the ways our family utilizes abundance to provide eggs year-round, storing eggs to use fresh. First and foremost, we eat a lot of fresh eggs in our home. And we did in Michigan. And we will again on our property once we have our chickens. Whether you gather eggs on your homestead or purchase them from a supermarket, you may wonder how best to store them in your kitchen. Eggs from your own tate, from your own hens need different handling than the ones available in stores, both for safety and ease of use. Store-bought eggs are already weeks old by the time they get to you. In the United States, eggs come pre-washed, so they shouldn't require any cleaning. However, this washing removes the protective coating that keeps out bacteria, so store-bought eggs must be refrigerated. As long as fresh eggs from your own birds are clean, they should not be washed. If you have dirty eggs, dip them in warm water.
make you feel
and
better.
let them sit for a moment before wiping them with a clean, wiping them clean with a cloth. These washed eggs should be used within a couple of days. Clean farm fresh eggs can last for weeks on your counter without refrigeration, assuming they have not been washed. A good rule of thumb is to count days at room temperature as you would weeks in cold storage. Our family eats enough eggs to keep them at room temperature, but if you have more eggs than you can eat in a couple of weeks, it's time to try some preservation methods. One, pickling. Now, I like beets and pickled eggs, and one of these days I'm going to get what I need to make them, and I'm going to make them. If you're looking for versatility and ease, pickling is a delicious way to preserve an abundance of eggs. Any kind of egg can be pickled. Chicken, duck, store-bought, farm fresh, your choice. One of the benefits of pickled eggs is they don't require canning and keep for weeks in the refrigerator. Pickled eggs are tasty in salads, on sandwiches, or as a high-protein snack on their own. Pickling is a great preservation method for beginners since it doesn't require any special equipment, though this technique is probably not for you if you have limited refrigerator space or don't like the flavor of vinegar. I love pickled eggs, and I love the beets in pickled eggs. Allow farm fresh eggs to age on your counter for a week or so before using them for this method because older eggs are easier to peel when they are hard boiled. You can hard boil and peel eggs a day or two before you pickle them. This will save you time on preservation day. As long as you don't fiddle with the ratios in your recipe, pickled eggs have room for lots of experimentation. Different kinds of vinegar impart a variety of flavors, and you can add sweetness, heat, or spice by including distinctive ingredients in your brine. Freezing. Another method is comfortable for beginners. Freezing is a great use for extra store-bought eggs or farm eggs that have to be washed because they were dirty. Much like pickled eggs, this method is easy to execute and requires no special equipment, but its usefulness depends on available freezer space, which we don't have. Frozen and thawed eggs are great for recipes that call for beaten eggs, like most baking or scrambled eggs. Freeze your eggs in the quantity you use most often. For our family, this is 6 eggs, but we have a larger family than most. Whatever your amount, crack the eggs into a bowl and then pour them into the freezer bags. Freezing eggs in a zip-top freezer bag allows you to lay the bag flat and then stack the bags once they are frozen solid. This method conserves freezer space. When you're ready to use the eggs, simply thaw the bag in a bowl in your refrigerator, then snip off the corner of the bag and pour the eggs directly into your pan or mixing bowl. Freeze drying. Freeze drying is a favorite way to preserve eggs on your homestead. It does, or on our homestead, it does require some upfront costs in the purchase of the necessary equipment, but we found that the security freeze-drying offers us in long-term food storage is worth the investment. I might invest in it, because it is a great way to preserve food. And it preserves the nutrients as well. Preserving eggs with a freeze-dryer retains more of an egg's original nutritional value than any other method. Additionally, freeze-dried eggs can last for literally decades in the inappropriate storage. The process itself requires minimal hands-on work, and the final product can be stored in cellars, pantries, or anywhere else that is cool and has low humidity. Be sure to package eggs immediately after they come out of the freeze dryer. Sitting out in the open allows eggs to reabsorb moisture, which could cause them to spoil in storage. We use glass jars for short-term storage, but for the long-term, we recommend vacuum sealing and including oxygen absorbers, which I'll have to buy a bunch of those. To rehydrate eggs, add equal parts freeze-dried egg powder to water and allow the mixture to sit for about 2 minutes. Then we use the eggs as we would any beaten eggs. Our family really enjoys scrambling our reconstituted eggs in the cast iron skillet over an open fire while camping. Liming. Homesteading Family's YouTube video on liming eggs is our most popular how-to video to date. And I'm actually going to try that. And when I do, I'll do a video on it. Viewers are so excited to rediscover this skill that was all but lost in the last 75 years. Liming eggs is a historical method of preserving eggs from a time when refrigeration was scarce and backyard chickens were abundant. The water glassing preservation technique has been around for hundreds of years, and it's simple, inexpensive, and highly effective. by submerging fresh eggs in water mixed with pickling lime, you can keep eggs fresh and ready to use for up to 2 years. This method does require more space than freeze drying or freezing, but the buckets of eggs can be left in a cool room and will require very minimal management. When you're ready to use your limed eggs, simply remove the number of eggs you need from the bucket and rinse them before using them. Once rinsed, the eggs can be used exactly like fresh ones. And in storage, you will need to watch your limed eggs for evaporation. If your eggs are exposed to the air, they will no longer be safe to eat. To prevent evaporation, either use a container with a lid or add a layer of olive oil to your water, then drape a sheet or towel over the top to keep dust and insects out. Blech. You can preserve eggs too. As you can see, there are a variety of methods to preserve eggs, with options for every budget, skill level, and storage capacity. And this isn't even all of them. We've learned so much over our years of keeping chickens, and our family has grown a lot at the same time. It takes quite a few eggs to feed 12 people. I still get excited every time I fill a basket with my beautiful and colorful home-raised eggs. But now, when winter brings fewer eggs, I don't worry and I don't head for the grocery store. I have just what I need for breakfast and baking tucked around my home, well-preserved and waiting for me. And as springtime brings its bounty and my countertop is heaped with eggs of all colors and sizes, I know what to do. With a plan and a little hard work, you can provide your family with eggs year-round. And why not start this year? All right, and that was it for preserving eggs. And there's the picture, which I will probably... I'll probably end up using that picture, so there you go. And I will get the title on this, and I will have Poey put the intro on it, and I will see you guys on the next video. Bye, guys.